So I used to show this to my students. I would go from an A, first finger on the G string, to a C sharp, third finger on the E string. I would then ask them if I could hit it the exact same spot 5 times in a row. They would laugh, and I would smile and start. Okay, so I hit it 5 times in a row, but can I miss it on purpose? Can I miss it playing a bit sharp on purpose? All right then. But just how am I doing this? Well, let me map it out for you on my fingering board. Start from the A first finger on the G string and go across the strings like this. We are now at an F sharp on the E string. Let's play a scale up to the C sharp. With the fingering 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And with that, we now have outlined the path we need to follow. Now, if the note values are an eighth followed by an eighth rest to a quarter note at, say, 60 on the metronome, obviously, what I just described would take way too much time. So we have to pare it down. We can do this by first going from the A to the F sharp with no stops in between. Be aware that this is achieved not by leading with our fingers, but with the elbow. Then shift from the F sharp to A with the first finger. Practicing this shift by doing 1 to 3, or F sharp to A, 3 to 1. Then 1 to 1, back to the A, 1 to 1. We can do 1, 2, 3, or A, B, C sharp, then 3, 2, 1. Next, play 1 to 3. Since I've mapped it all out, I visually now know how to get where I'm going. If I follow my path and aware of what my body is doing to accomplish this, after a little bit of repetitive practicing, I can get there repeatedly. I'm reminded of a story about a French violin student who was having a conversation with his teacher during which he explained how difficult it was for him to play in tune. The teacher looked at him and said, "But what's the problem? Just figure out where to put your finger and keep putting it there." Well, okay. I used to slide into the B flat in the first movement of the Sibelius Concerto. One measure before number six. I used to slide into it like this. But when I played it for Miss DeLay, she told me that I should go to the B-flat without the slide. This totally destabilized me as the idea of doing this kind of shift, or should I say jump, scared me. But I did what she said and tried to work through my fear. What I now admit is that it never occurred to me that to do what she asked didn't mean that I had to lose the shift. It simply meant that I needed to take my bow off the string so you wouldn't hear the shift. Doing it this way, I could map out the distance, practicing it from the F natural on the E string to the octave F, then play F, G, A, B flat, or 1, 2, 3, 3. And then I could practice it like this. This led me to understand when creating a path to go from low to high across strings, we should do it like this. We shouldn't do it this way. Do take care. Ciao.